John Morton blips the throttle as he manhandles the Mustang's large, thin wooden wheel. He sets up the car into the wide, right-hand sweeper traced by small orange cones with the nonchalance of a man who's turned a car in anger hundreds of thousands of times. We hit the apex, and he pours on the throttle, unleashing all of the V8's 289 cubic inches and working over the four-speed manual as we barrel down the short front stretch of the Streets of Willow circuit. Morton prefers Big Willow, the track next door to Streets at the famed Willow Springs facility about 2 hours northeast of Los Angeles. It's easy to understand why. It's a much faster, longer circuit. It's where years ago he tested a car just like this and raced a car just like this. A Mustang built in Venice Beach, California, near the shores of the Pacific. A GT350R much like this one. The new, old car Morton is hustling around Streets might as well be one of the race-prepped Shelby GT350RS Morton, and others like Jerry Titus campaigned at Willow, Riverside, and elsewhere across the country, and men like Peter Brock helped design, and the then 17-year-old Jim Marietta wrenched on the 1965. Built by the original Venice Crew, OVC, this one is close to the real thing but with new independent rear suspension. Authenticity was the primary goal of the Venice Crew. They decided to offer 36 recreation cars, the same number they built back in the day. Back at the staging area, our own race say Sandy Pilgrim is about to strap into a GT350 Mustang, built by Revology, that looks very much like the Wimbledon white and Guardsman blue striped OVC machine Morton and I are in, only without the roll cage, race seats, and other old school high performance flourishes. Instead, the Nappa leather inside is sourced from the same supplier Porsche uses, the floor is swathed in plush wool carpet, and the headliner is done in Alcantara. It has comfortable bucket seats, and a navigation, infotainment system complete with a backup camera. Pilgrim pushes the stop, start button, and its Ford Performance prepped 5.0-liter Coyote V8 with 435 horsepower mated to a Trimec T56 close ratio 6-speed manual clears its fuel-injected throat. Automotive industry veteran Tom Scarpello, who spent the better part of two decades primarily at Ford and Nissan in various roles including manufacturing and product planning, founded Revology Cars in 2014 out of Orlando, Florida, with the goal of creating a series of Mustangs with modern conveniences while celebrating the past. The approach is retro-mod at its core, but much more than that, Scarpello's vision as chief Revologist has been to create a company that takes a world-class, assembly-line approach to building cars he learned during his career. The official stamp of Shelby Automobiles and Ford makes Revology all the more legit. When it comes to being legit, you can't be much more in Mustang circles than folks like Morton, Brock, and Marietta. These are men who spent their salad days being cajoled, cussed out, and inspired by Carroll Shelby, building cars on a wing and a prayer in Shelby American's impossibly cramped, 10,000-square-foot shop in Venice. When Peter Brock says you should do something, you probably should.